I'm Andrew Holcomb, and I'm here with Dagger Kayaks, and we're going to talk about the green boat today. The green boat is pretty cool. I think it actually has one of the coolest kind of background histories of any boat at Dagger. This boat was developed over a period of 2 to 3 years. When we started out, it was specifically designed for the Green River Narrows race, which is on the Green River right outside of Hendersonville, North Carolina. And the more that we kind of got along with it, the more we realized that, you know, it wasn't just going to be for people that wanted to race it Whitewater, that it really could expand out to, you know, anyone that wanted to do a distance race that had any Whitewater in it, or if you just want a bigger boat. Obviously, it's really long, so it's got a lot of speed. So if you're paddling long distances, you want a big kayak with lots of room. And then another cool thing that developed over time is like the training aspect of it, or the physical fitness. You can use this boat to do attainments, just paddling upstream in it, or like I mentioned before, just going downstream. So this boat is really cool. It had a long history really utilizing Team Dagger to develop it over a period of years to come out with what I think is actually a really cool and boat that you can use for a lot more things than we originally had in mind. So kind of starting with the features of this boat, what makes it the green boat? What makes it fun? First of all, you notice, you just see it, it's the length. This boat's about 11'6", 11'7". So that really gives it speed. This thing goes down the river really well. You know, and this was something that we really wanted it to do with the racing background in mind, but it also has become really just fun to go down the river having that much speed. But the cool thing is, as you notice, like the Nomad, it actually has a pretty good bit of rocker. And what this does is allow it to be incredibly nimble. This boat paddles a lot shorter than it is long, which is very cool. It allows you to do very tight turns, kind of spin on a dime. It's not going to be nearly as maneuverable as some of the shorter boats, but for one that's 11 foot, it's pretty cool. And then that bow rocker really allows it to get over things, and that combined with the stern rocker, and you can boof this thing, which is pretty cool. I started paddling a long time ago, and those early boats, they were hard to boof. This thing is not hard to boof. And then in addition to that, you know, it's a displacement hull, so again, really easy transitions from primary stability to second stability. It rolls really well and has a long point of balance, which makes a pretty stable paddle down the river. And on top of that, again, you can see we have a chine in here. And what this chine does, it's just a little bit of an edge, and it's super helpful for a boat this long, because you can drop that and you can actually feel it engage, and that really allows you to make really nice, crisp turns and really drive this thing down the river. And then moving on, same thing, we got a peak deck. See, there's just a little bit of a ridge running down the bow of this thing that just lets it shed water, kind of resurface well. And that extends all the way up to the front. You can actually see that the very front of this boat has a little bit of a ridge on it. What that does is just help split the water, and that just makes it faster. Safety features. You got bow and stern, grab handles, just good points of attachment. If you need that in a sticky situation on the river. We also have the creek seat, which makes it nice and stiff, combined with the step out pillar. The step out pillar is really pretty cool. You notice it's made out of plastic. And what that does, and this is especially critical for a boat this big, is it makes the bow of this thing really resistant to compressing or folding. And so you want that in a boat this long. And in addition, you have the little curve here, and what that does is just allow you to utilize that in the case of emergency that you would need to get out of this boat quickly. You have enough room to actually get your foot onto that. You don't have to bring your foot all the way out to where a standard wall would be at the edge of the cockpit. You can actually get it onto that and use it as a step. It's possible to get out of this boat without ever using your hand.